Hey, what's up, guys? This is Izzy or Sick Izzy, and today I have another Photoshop tutorial for you. I think this is going to be one of those long ones. Hopefully, it's not long, but I'm going to try to make it as short as possible. What we're going to be doing here is I'm actually going to be more showing you the refine edge tool on how on a studio kind of shot, and I'm going to show you how that really comes in handy. So first, what we're gonna do here is well, I'm gonna show you the steps that I took. Added a color fill, and then I extracted the girl, darkened up the shadows a bit, and then finally added a dual tone. And I'm also gonna show you how to do it. So let's get to it. First, I'm gonna go ahead and just delete all of these. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna group them in case this tutorial goes wrong. All right. So first, what I'm gonna do here is I'm going to go ahead and get my quick selection tool, and I'm just gonna go around and select this whole kind of girl out of the picture. And the reason I'm using this tool is because with the refine edge tool, you don't really have to be accurate when you're selecting. Photoshop simply has to know what the object is. And as you can see here, I accidentally went over the edge and kind of selected all of this. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna click your Alt or Option key, and that'll just put like a little minus sign, and you'll notice that you can actually just erase some of this. So click away, and yeah, and this is kind of it's one of the more complex tools of Photoshop. Not really. All right, so like I said, you don't have to be really accurate. You have a rough selection like this, and but you do want to get as not as accurate, but as close as you can to selecting your object. So now, once we have that, we're just going to go up here and go to Refine Edge. And first of all, I'm going to go on here, and I'm going to set this little arrow, and I'm going to go to Overlay. And this shows you everything that you have selected, and everything that's not selected is on. It's red. So now, with your smart radius brush or your refine edge brush, I really don't know what it's called, you can actually go around the edges and just select what you want. So for example, this, I'm just gonna select all of this right here because we want all of that, and you know, we might want the shadows as well, so we're just gonna go around here, select these shadows, and Photoshop would do its job with doing so. And we want this kind of shadow out here, and maybe we want, obviously we want her hand, and just kind of want to select, have a selection like that maybe. Okay, here, and this part right here, and our hair, obviously. Now this is where this tool really comes in handy, is with hair. And something that's always troubled me with the previous Photoshops, but this one actually does a really good job with that. And if you over select something, like you don't want something selected, you can always click the Alt or Options key, and you'll actually just erase that part. But at the same time, Photoshop will recalculate what it's selecting, and it'll actually make a different kind of selection sometimes. But you just gotta be careful with it. And yeah, we have something like that maybe. And around the ankle, around here. Whoops. Maybe on her back. You know, just kind of notice these details. Little spots here, here, and you know, Photoshop will do its job. Now, once you have that done, we're gonna go select the smart radius, and I'm gonna go ahead and bump this up to about 7 pixels. But depending on your image, it may vary. So I'm just gonna bump this up. Maybe it looks good, I guess. And what that does is actually gives Photoshop an even better selection of what the object is, you know what I mean? It gives it a better idea of what the object is, and not is, but more as knowing what pixels go together, and so now I'm gonna select on black and white, and you'll see we have a nice selection like this, and this is actually a pretty decent selection. And now I'm gonna just go ahead and feather this out maybe about 0.5 pixels. Create a little bit more contrast, because contrast is good sometimes. And then finally, I'm just gonna decontaminate colors about 50%. If you want, you can bump it up to 100%, but sometimes when you're trying to go back, it actually fills that color in with a different color that it was before. So, 50% is good. Now I'm going to show you the original. This is what we had at first, and this is what we ended up with. So you can see how Photoshop does a really good job with that. So now I'm just going to click OK, and Photoshop does its little job, and we have an image or a selection like this. And now you'll see that our new layer has like a layer mask, and that's so you can go back and re-edit some of the things that you kind of made transparent or whatever. So as you can see, her hand is a little bit transparent. Maybe the blanket over here is a little bit transparent. That's all easily fixable. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna add a solid color, and I'm gonna add a kind of really bright green, and this will actually help me see what is transparent and what isn't. So as you can see here, the blanket is kind of transparent there. We don't want that, so we're gonna select the layer mask, get our brush tool, and select white because this is what we want. So we're just gonna go over that right there. And now you wanna go around your image and go ahead and do that to the entire image. And I'm just gonna maybe pause this. I'm not too sure because I don't want the video to run too long for you guys. But that's basically what you gotta do for now. You can see the hand here. I actually need to bring back a lot on that hand. So yeah, I'm actually gonna pause this and then come back. All right, so I pretty much got everything. I think possibly the only thing was the hand and the hair a little bit, but that's pretty much it. So now you'll see that if we change the solid color down here, we can actually get a different background, and that's actually what we're gonna do. So that said, we're going to add a different background, and I think I already selected I already have the color code for the background that I wanted. So we're gonna have something like this. Now do keep in mind that if you see like these halo edges around here, let's see, maybe around the hair somewhere, which is most commonly around the hair. Those actually help you with detecting your light. So for example, if we do something like this, obviously the lighting isn't correct. You can't really have a bright background, I mean a bright foreground with a dark background. So it kind of helps you coordinate your lights and your background. So see, if we have something like this, it looks good. I mean, you can't really see the halos and whatnot. But if you have something darker, then it doesn't really look good. It kind of helps you out at the same time, but you can actually get rid of those by going back to your layer mask. So again, I'm gonna put the color code that I want. So something like this. I'm just gonna click OK. And now you'll see that the shadows are a little bit brown for some reason. And I'm gonna show you how to fix that now. What we wanna do is, I'm actually going to go back and change this black. I'm so sorry, guys. And then I'm gonna go zoom in, and I'm gonna add a curves adjustment layer. And in this curves adjustment layer, I'm gonna go ahead and select the black eyedropper tool, and I'm gonna select about right here or right here. And what that does, it makes everything that is about approximately that color and everything that's approximately that value, it'll make it black. So we have something like this, and you can see it darkened up the image. That's not what we want. We just want the shadows. So I'm gonna go ahead and delete this layer mask, and now I'm gonna Alt or Option add another layer mask. I mean, yeah, re-add the layer mask, but this time it's all black. And now I'm gonna go ahead and go back here and add the color code that I want, Control V. And on this curves adjustment layer, we select the layer mask, get our brush tool, and we want the white foreground color as a foreground color. And we're gonna zoom in, make our brush a little bit bigger. Make sure it's a really soft brush as well, something like that. And just gonna go. Oh, also, you want to make sure it's a clipping mask, so you're gonna Alt or Option click between the layers, and that'll actually make it a clipping mask. So now we can just darken up those shadows and whatnot. Obviously, I'm not really doing a really good job right now, and that's because I'm kind of not rushing, but I want to kind of keep this video as short as possible. So we have something like this. Okay. So I mean that looks good, and maybe some of the halo around here we can actually darken up as well. Some of the halo around here, and yeah, looks good. All right, so we have something like that, and now what we're gonna do is actually, I'm going to show you how you can add a kind of a dual tone, and this is how a lot of dual tones are done, and it's really easy and really simple. So what you're going to do is you want to add a solid color right here, and whoa, that's weird. All right, I'm sorry about that. That was really weird. But anyways, so what you want to do, you want to add like a color, maybe like this, something like this, and just going to click OK. Now for the blending option, you want to go down to exclusion, and that'll kind of do that kind of effect, and you can go ahead and play around with them. So I think I'm gonna want like a little darker red, and something like this. That actually looks really nice, and you'll see this kind of it's kind of dual tone in a lot of photographs with in like magazines or stuff, or like pop culture, just a lot of images, I guess. So I'm gonna use that image and maybe reduce the opacity a little bit because we don't want it too much. And I'm guessing that's pretty much it for the tutorial. I know I kind of went by this a little bit fast, but I hope you kind of understand how the Refine Edge tool works and how you can decontaminate a lot of the colors and fix some of those halos. So I hope you learned something in this tutorial. And if you did, please feel free to like the video. And again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.